this morning, I have some work to do, and I was looking for an expert, somebody who was good at building and might be able to help me out in the new addition that I'm building on my house. So, all right. So, if I was looking for an expert in helping me build something for my house, what kind of person would that be? What do we call that person? A handyman, maybe, or a handy lady? Construction worker, what else? Not a plumber. A carpenter. I'd be looking for a carpenter. A carpenter is somebody who has authority or knows how to do it, because sometimes when I try to hammer it, because I'm not an authority, sometimes it goes in straight. Sometimes not. Just kind of depends on my day. Many a time I have had to pull out a bent nail. How about anybody here when they're trying to hang something up? And you got to start over again. That, no, that was a screw, but I wanted to do one. Ethan is commenting on my props. So, yeah, that'll take a long time to hammer in. So, a carpenter would be who I would choose. What if I had a plug in my pipes, Leslie just said, I would call who? You just said, if I had my pipes plugged. No. A plumber, right, that would be my authority in that area. Yeah, your husband, maybe, yeah. So that's what our story is about today, choosing the right person to fit the right job. Somebody who has power and authority in something. And in our scripture today, people were a little surprised because Jesus has just started out on his teaching tour, if we'll call it. And they weren't all aware of him and knew that he knew what he was talking about. He is the authority on God's love. He is the authority on how to share that love. He is the authority on how to spread that from person to person. And he was just starting out and they were a little surprised that he was somebody of authority. Now, somebody of authority who knows what they're doing, do they have to be loud and boisterous and say their point with a very strong word? Do they have to be like that? Do you think that's how Sally sounds? Do you have to say it like that? Does that make you authority? Or could you say, God is love, God is kind, in a voice like that? Would that still be authority? What do you think? What do you think? Yes, I think so. Just power and authority doesn't mean loud, because I bet we have all met somebody who very loudly tells you how to do something, but really doesn't know how to do it. They just had the loudest voice in the room. So sometimes we meet people who are very loud and tell us things that are not necessarily the right things and the power and the authority. So our scripture tells us today to look for those people in our lives that are ones that are going to guide us and teach us, and God being number one up here in the teachings of Jesus, to show us the way our lives are going to be. But we'll meet teachers and friends and neighbors and parents and grandparents who are also going to show us the way. And we need to listen and watch for those who are teaching us in the paths of God. Let us pray. Dear God, you have given us the tools. Help us to listen to those around us and to read your words in the scripture and hear the words from those teachers around us here at Pilgrim, showing us the authority on you, on God's love, your kindness, your compassion, and the joy for living. Amen.